Silly question, really.
Oh, he's some ton, isn't he?
He has changed enormously in the last 24 hours.
24 hours, he's changed completely.
Huge change.
Completely.
And I said to him this morning, and he said, really, in what way? I said, I don't know, you've...
Actually, I haven't spoken to him at all in the last 24
lost
hours.
Lost your strutting peacockness to a certain extent. Plus, he's become much gentler.
More humble.
Mm. More humble? I have to talk to him.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, he's had.
I don't know. I have a feeling that underneath his makeup is not the Quatermass and the pit that he's been describing to us.
It's a vulnerable,
of course.
Vulnerable guy.
Vulnerable, soft human being. But he puts on a hell of an act.
Hell of an act, yeah.
I mean, I found him quite scary, although mesmeric, as we were saying. Quite scary.
Yeah.
I now see fake confidence.
Yeah.
Which is all a shell.
Yeah. Jodie's probably the same. She probably would like
to. I definitely think she
is. The feminists will be outraged at this, but I think myself that inside she would like to be a wife and a mother and...
She longs to be loved.
Absolutely.
I don't believe
she craves
that,
love.
I can't believe that she wants to go the rest of her life snogging people.
No, but she also craves to be a star.
Yeah. A talentless star.
Well, she thinks she is.
There's nothing worse than that.
But what does she think her talent is?
I've never seen her. I had no idea.
According to Preston, she's really, really famous. I mean, Preston asked her, I nearly burst out laughing, if there was a waxwork of her in Madame Tussauds.
I actually did think that she sang somewhere. That was why. How she got famous.
I said yesterday.
What did you say to me? You thought she was going to win.
No, I didn't.
You did.
Yeah, you did.
Yes, you did.
Yeah, you did.
If she wins, I'm leaving Britain.
Yeah. 12:46 p.m. Big Brother has delivered the housemates shopping. As they failed their shopping task, they have a budget of only £1 per head per day. The housemates have spent £4.98 on rolling tobacco.
So either we can decide to have...
post-meal cigarettes, one each.
Certain amount per day each, like 3 or 4 a day, make them in advance, give them to you, and then it's your responsibility.
Yeah.
Or at certain times of the day, you ask...
A limited amount each that make them last. If I don't get one in a minute, I'm going to scream.
Okay.
Pete comes to the diary room.
Good afternoon, Big Brother. I'm really excited today, but I'm also very worried. Some borderline hysterical. If I go, I'll miss George and I'll miss... I'll miss George and I'll miss Michael and I'll miss Preston and I'll miss Maggot. And I adore Dennis as well. Dennis, who I've now renamed Fluffy. Because I think Dennis is a really... he's a little fluffy kitten trapped in a big old black man's body. It's fantastic, and Tracy's just great. But I just kind of want to consciously remove myself from bad energy, and I've really kind of screwed up because I perpetrated what I accused Jodie of is to... put out bad feeling into the world, but I consciously want to separate myself from her. She's probably a really, really nice girl in the environment that she thrives in, but it's really not my environment. Maybe the British public who view me think, oh, look at that twat. He's desperate for attention. People do think that about me because the way I dress, I'm desperate for attention, but it's actually quite the opposite. It's a reality for me, and if attention is one of the side effects, well, so be it. I'm kind of like a hothouse plant. I need to be in my own greenhouse, and I'm out of it, and my eyes are dried up, my nose is bunged up, my skin's falling to pieces, and I can do it, you know, but it's hard. So if I'm to stay in any longer, by the time I leave, I'll look like a mix of Bella Emberg and Rolf Harris.
Am I not heavy for you?
What's going on here?
£1:52 p.m.
I miss walking. I do a lot of walking every day.
All of the housemates are in the house.
Ruler is Mrs. Robinson, isn't she?
I'm here to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know.
Whoa.
God rest you, please, Mrs. Robinson.
You want me to seduce you, boy?
Heaven holds a place for those who pray.
Hey, hey, hey.
Okay, that was 10. Good workout.
Doing number 10.
What are you doing there? Just sit-ups and that?
Sit-ups and weights and the bike and the treadmill and...
It's good down here, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 14,
15.
Oh.
You can put your feet on
Maggie's
feet.
Like that.
Oh, God. I can't keep up.
You want to sit right here?
Thank you.
Do I want to sit right there? Yeah. I'll blame break you if I sit right there.
Oh, much better. Thanks.
Oh.
Am I not heavy for you?
No.
What's going on here?
Oh, that's a good shot.
It doesn't look like that fun.
Oh, helping him.
Do it again.
No.
Think before you act.
Don't worry now.
But Trace, let's do one hard one.
No, you can do it with Maggie.
No, come on.
No.
Come here, Maggot. Girl. Ah, quit being a gay
Maggot,
bitch.
Protect me.
Come here.
Maggot!
I can't. Dennis is bigger than me.
No.
Come on. Come on, no. Come on, ankles right here. Let's do the leg ones. Yeah. You ready?
Watch it doesn't fall on the carpet, Maggot.
Okay, sure.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Five more. 1, 2.
Oh, okay, no.
Four or 3 p.m. Big Brother has given George, Judy and Pete their suitcases to pack ahead of tonight's eviction.
It's got the panic poos almost. I don't know how we got this all in. That's it, like it was like three
Don't
people.
Get it all in.
I'm it's dressing light and easy. I'll put the stuff on my right way out here. Look. Ow, my fucking ankle. Now more bruises, you fucking bastard.
Maggot is in the diary room.
Maggot, could you describe for Big Brother what the atmosphere is like in the house today?
Sure. It's good, but not great. I can imagine they might be quite nervous with the anticipation of leaving the house. They don't know which way it's going to go. They don't know how people are going to vote or not vote, as the case may be. You don't know which way the public's going to vote for people. I'd be pleased if Pete did leave. Not for any bad reason, because I get on with Pete and I was quite surprised by his character. At the end of the day, he comes from Liverpool. He has a marvellous sense of humour. You can't judge a book by his cover. I know he walks, struts around here like Danny LaRue, with his arse hanging out. If George was evicted from the house this evening, I wouldn't be so happy. He's a good team player. He fights for the good of the cause and the good of the team. He likes a democratic debate. He knows what makes people tick. He knows what makes people happy. And that's what's great.
How would you feel if Jodie was evicted tonight?
Well, pleased for her, because she would, from what I can gather, be happy in the fact that she doesn't have to be surrounded by us. And that she could drink when she wants, smoke when she wants, eat what she wants, and have sex with who she wants.
5:32 p.m. Today is Tracy's birthday. It's also Friday the 13th. Unluckily for Tracy, this means she must retrieve skulls from a swamp in order to win herself a birthday party.
You got it?
I don't know what the hell's going to be.
Oh, it can't be nothing bad. It's only probably slime and that.
It's only dead housemates.
Yeah! 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 Yeah!
Riders go! Riders go! Riders go!
Head under! Head under! Head under!
Head under!
Go right
head
on,
Tracy.
Head under?
Yes!
Yeah!
Oh my God, just get the skull.
Head under!
Let's go!
That is really odd.
Oh, fucking gross.
Come on, dude.
Come on, Tracy!
Good girl!
Under the net!
Be careful!
Under the net, Tris!
Go in that shit.
Oh. Speed up, darling! Come on!
Good girl! Come on!
Come on!
Come on!
Come on!
Come on!
Come on!
Thank you.